Good day, my friends. Time to tell you a story or two. I'm going to show you some clips of me cutting the grass just day before yesterday. It rained all day yesterday, and them dandelions are springing back up out here like nobody's business. You wouldn't think dandelions could grow that fast in just a day and a half, but they have grown up a good 2-3 inches. By next week I'll be out here cutting again. Well, I didn't think my hummingbird bushes were going to come back. I went ahead and started pulling this one up, and I realized it was growing new leaves. So I replanted it and trimmed it. I trimmed that one. I've dug up some areas in between here without doing a whole lot of straightening with a shovel. Planted some flower seeds from the dollar store. Marigold hummingbird blend. And if they don't grow, it won't be because I didn't throw them in the ground. Planted some there, a couple places out there by the bird feeder and the bird bath, between those two bushes and those, and along here. I threw some in these flower pots right here that had tomatoes in them last year. Got some planted out there by the signal box. I think the wife paid $1 a piece for these at Dollar General or somewhere. The dollar store might not grow at all. But they're in the ground. They sure weren't going to grow in the box. I've shared a lot of stories with my viewers over the years about what a daresome child I was, trying to walk a tightrope between two trees 20 feet off the ground. There was a story I told. I'll put a link in the description. Some of you might find it of interest. The time when I was a kid and I wanted to be a paratrooper. I was big on army men, and I wanted to be a paratrooper. If you get a chance, look in the description here and watch that video. I was thinking about a time when I was about, it was around the same time of my paratrooper days. We lived in McCray, Georgia, out in the country. And across this big field area, probably bigger than what I got across the street there, back beyond the trees was a cow pond. And I was out there around the barn and found a big old piece of tin. I got the bright idea I could build myself a canoe. I got out there with a hammer and beat that piece of tin up on the sides and tapered the ends down and crimped it around. I worked on that thing for a week. Got it bent up in the shape of a canoe. We carried that thing all the way down to that cow pond. And bear in mind, we could not swim. I mean, I later in life learned how to swim, but at that time, I couldn't swim a lick. Well, got in my canoe and started out across that pond. My brother wouldn't go with me. I got my own canoe. Got out in the middle of that pond, and it tipped over and dumped me in the pond. Down I went. Well, I flopped around out there for a little while like I was going to drown, and I realized if I stand up, I could touch the bottom. I was probably, 4 feet tall, and it was up to my chin deep. I mean, my nose was just barely out of the water, and some places my nose was underwater. So I kind of hopped to the surface each time. Each time I hopped a little closer to the edge of the pond. I hopped until it was shallow enough that I could wade out of that pond. That was the end of my canoeing days.